course, that's not his record of amateur. That's his professional amateur. His professional record.
Let's meet the champion.
Tough-looking guy, I gotta say that for him.
Did you hear many cheers in the audience for him? They sounded like boos to me.
Unless his nickname is Moose.
No, this is a pro-Lora crowd.
118-pound Moose. Here's the tail of the tape. 5'7 for Zaragoza, 5'6 for Lora. Zaragoza with the reach advantage, 68-66. And neither one with any kind of a punch.
Well, I think Lara's knockouts come less from the punches than from people just falling down out of exhaustion, if you're watching.
Championship of the world, Daniel Zaragoza of Mexico, the champion in white. Miguel Happy Lora in black, Colombia. The challenger, Stephen Bass, Bert Sugar, Tamiami Fairgrounds in Miami, Florida.
One quick note as we watch, it's Zaragoza not only in the white trunks, but in the southpaw stance.
Zaragoza, lefty, and as you can see, like most lefties, does not have the good crisp jab. Just kind of waves it out there, uses it to measure distances between he and his opponent. And so far, there's a lot of distance between them.
I think taxi cabs wouldn't shorten this distance.
Good right hand by Lora.
Picked off by Zaragoza.
Then it wasn't such a good right hand by Lora.
Oh, it looked beautiful. It just had no effect.
Lora in the middle of the ring. Zaragoza in the middle of the ring. Zaragoza with a tentative left hook.
He was sort of reaching with that.
There's a left hook that did land. Although there are those who think that for left-handers you should say left cross, but there's no such thing as a left cross.
Well, there is for a left-hander if you push it.
Well, the purists say left hook.
The purist will say it was a left hand.
Very good. Good left hand by Zaragoza.
He's the only one showing any offense at the moment, left hand or not. Lara is very happy to be back there, away out of his range, trying to figure out Zaragoza.
Well, obviously trying to make him miss, but he hasn't made him pay for the misses yet.
No, I haven't seen him throw punches yet. Maybe I'm missing something with the misses, but I doubt it.
Zaragoza establishing himself in the middle of the ring as the champion. There's the first punch. Good right-left combination.
Landed. Great combination.
Zaragoza missed wild, and he paid.
But look how fast Lara was. That's another thing to watch. The quickness, a right hand, the very quickness of his right hand.
Of course, every time Lara breathes deeply here, this crowd's going to go wild. At some time during the fight, we'll probably hear the chant, happy, happy. Good right hand right on the nose.
You now know why Zaragoza is called the face fighter. He just caught one right in his face.
Well, no head movement whatsoever by Zaragoza. Zaragoza's bouncing, but he's bouncing in one place. Neither head nor shoulders or anything moving. He's right there to be hit.
And Lara is moving.
Lara's moving. We're in round number two. WBC Bantamweight Championship of the World. Miguel Happy Lora in the black trunks is the challenger, going up against Daniel Zaragoza of Mexico. In the white trunks, the champion, Stephen Bass, Burt Randolph Sugar, Tamiami Fairgrounds in Miami, Florida. And I scored the first one for Happy Lora.
I did too, though. The crisper punches, albeit there were only four of them. But they all landed full force, and they were fast. And what he's got is Zaragoza reaching in. Look at that. He countered beautifully at the beginning of the round. Yes, Zaragoza's throwing more. Yes, Zaragoza is missing more.
Well, in the first round, we saw Lora dancing around, picking his spots. Right here at the beginning of the round, Lora came right out and threw a few quick punches.
Zaragoza is trying to press the action, but he just can't get close enough to do so.
Well, he has no idea how to cut the ring off, that's obvious. There's Zaragoza pouring with the left hand. Lora throws the right in there, good right to the body. Ooh, a miss with the left.
Shoots him right hand crazy. He doesn't set it up with the left, he just wounds it. But it's got a home-picking instinct.
And he's got that style where he bobs and ducks his left shoulder and then steps in with the right hand. When you see that bob and that left shoulder go down. And you know there's a right coming right behind it.
There he went again.
There's the bad right.
And he's got Zaragoza reaching. And he counters every time he reaches with his left. In other words, if he can get Zaragoza to extend his left, he comes over with the right hand.
And, of course, that round marker is wrong. It really is only round two. Yep, now they got it right. Good right underneath, right uppercut.
Zaragoza's hands are so much faster. I mean, I'm sorry, I take that back. Lora's hands.
Yeah, Zaragoza's hands are about as fast as slow motion here.
I take that back. Rewind.
Zaragoza is getting close to Lora. Lora bounces away very easily and then beats him, counter punches him. There's a left.
There they go, Hoppy.
There they go. There's the Hoppy champ.
Hoppy or we in our work.
Good pity pat left to the body by Zaragoza.
Look at.
We're in round number three. WBC Bantamweight Championship of the World. Daniel Zaragoza of Mexico in the white. The champion, the challenger, Miguel Happy Lora of Colombia in the black, Stephen Bass, Burt Randolph, Sugar, Tamiami, Fairgrounds, Miami, Florida. And after two, you have it?
I gave the last round to Zaragoza against better judgment. First round to Lora. But Lora's already thrown more punches this round than he did all at last.
And I scored the first two rounds for Miguel Lora. Good right hand on the jaw, good right over the top of the head. By Lora. Lora is now stepping in. Lora's not moving away all that much after the first two rounds. Good right hand.
He knows how to counter. He knows how to counter.
And he's getting planted. There's another good solid right.
Coming after a Zaragoza punch.
Right. Exactly. And that's what they say. The best way to fight a lefty is lead with your right. Another wild right hand. Wild left. I think all the respect for Zaragoza is gone now, Bert. He's not moving away. He's coming at him. Good right to the body.
He's right in front of him. It's always the right hand. As you said, that's the best way to fight a southpaw.
Another right over the ear.
And he's covering up well.
Boom, right on the jaw with a right hand.
Zaragoza got an infrequent left.
Misses with the left. Takes a left right to the body.
A left right to the body. I like that.
Mm-hmm.
That's
so it was almost a left right, but he faked the left and he hit him with the right.
That certainly clears up nothing.
Zaragoza back to the body with the right hand. No, Lora back to the right hand. Good right on the button again. Lead right hand by Lora. Yeah. Lora with another lead right that misses. A good left over the eye. Another right to the body by Lora. Yes, but.
Watch every time Zaragoza lets that left hand and leaves it out there. In comes the boom counter by Lora.
Good left right by Zaragoza. Zaragoza with a right over the ear. Happy just missing that shot.
He's looking for places to put his right hand.
Well, he's finding him. He found one right there on Zaragoza's nose. He's bombing away with that lead right. There it is again, two times in a row, right to the body. Another right to the face. A good left hook, a left jab.
Yeah, he's got a jab.
Yep.
But it just, you know, bombs away. It's all right hands.
And Lora is not moving away in this round like he did in the first two. He's coming at him like he's trying to knock him out right here. Well, that's the right way. Lead with those rights. Another right off his temple.
You wouldn't suspect he's thrown less than 50 lead rights this round, have you?
Not yet. At the end of round number three. Lora looking like the champion in round number three. Lots of lead rights.
Almost every punch he threw was a lead right.
And almost every one of them landed somewhere on Zaragoza. Here we go. Here's one of them. Boom. Boom. Another one on the head. Boom. One to the body. Here comes another one. Bing, right off the nose. There's the jab, and when he jabs, Zaragoza got a punch in.
Zaragoza is sucking some wind here.
I don't think he expected Lora to come out as stronger. Not in this round. Championship of the world. Zaragoza in white, Lora in black. Zaragoza the champion of Mexico. Happy Lora of Colombia in black, the challenger. Stephen Bass, Burt Randolph Sugar at Tamiami Fairgrounds in Miami, Florida. I scored it 30-27 after three rounds. Three rounds for Happy Lora.
And I have it just a little off the mark at 29-28 Lora. Two rounds to one.
And in the first two rounds, Lora was kind of testing Zaragoza, moving around. Last round, he just came out after him.
He was bombs away. Lora is now coming out. Zaragoza is now coming out and at least trying to force the action and land a few, something he did not do in round three.
But Happy is not bouncing away. He's right in front of Zaragoza, like he's challenging him to slug it out.
And making him miss. Not making him pay. But making him miss.
Good right hand again. There's that solid right hand lead. There's a right-left combination that falls short. Zaragoza tentative with the left, misses with three punches. Missed by a foot with each one.
But it was as much Lora's doing as his missing.
Lora leaps in with the left. Lora missing some wild uppercuts himself. This is turning into a slugfest. Good uppercut that landed that time. That stepped Zaragoza back.
Lora's showing some good defense here. I mean, making him miss is a hard, hard act.
Zaragoza still trying to find Lora in this ring. Lora's still pretty much in front of him, but just out of firing range, except when he wants to fire, and then he steps in hard with those good, solid right-hand leads. There's Zaragoza pulling with the left and getting belted with the right hand. As you said, every time he sticks out that left.
Boom.
There's a left underneath by Lora.
And he's throwing the left this round. He did not last round.
Last round it was all right.
It was all right for him.
And not all right for Zaragoza. Zaragoza misses the wild uppercut. Lora shoots the jab out as Zaragoza was moving away. There's that left uppercut
he's
by
trying to work. He's trying to work that one inside. He must see something. He's throwing a lot of uppercuts. They're not landing.
Boom! Oh! Right hand. That right hand leads. And wait a minute, folks. We may be going home early. Look at this. Woo! Where am I?
Neutral corner. You can't find any one of the four.
Dolphin Carpet.
And here in round number five, WBC Bantamweight Championship of the World, Zaragoza, the champion in white, on his back in the last round, sent there by Miguel Happy Lora in the black trunks from Colombia, the challenger. And Lora is now coming after Zaragoza, and down he goes again.
Another right.
A backward somersault into the corner.
I haven't seen that since Carl Mildenberger against Muhammad Ali.
We may be going home early here. This fight may just about be over. Good solid right hand by Lora. Lora coming at Zaragoza with both hands. Can Zaragoza last this round? Can he last the fight? If not like this, rights, lefts raining in on him from every angle. Good solid left to the kidney. Ooh, an illegal punch, and Zaragoza's down again. One more time. Two times in this round.
Remember, Lara's only had 12 KOs in 22 fights.
Zaragoza is taking one incredible beating here in round five after having been down in four.
Nobody is seated. Everybody is up. They're all expecting the end, and
Zaragoza looks like it's the end. Now he's on his bicycle. Does he know enough to stay away?
What else has he got to be on? He hasn't thrown anything this round. He's still suffering from a knockdown of round four. And he's down twice. He got butted. I don't think it makes no never mind.
He got butted. He got banged, too. He's getting beat up with both hands. Zaragoza, another right.
I mean, Lora now has three things working, both hands and a head.
Look at this. Lora puffing Zaragoza over the top of his head. I don't see how Zaragoza's standing up. That last two knockdowns, once a backward somersault into the corner, and then a left right to the kidneys. Oh, he went right down. He crunched.
The rumper. Those hurt. Those hurt. I felt that one from here.
And Lora still going at him with both hands, banging away. Missing a wild punch. Here's Zaragoza coming back. Wild with the left. But he looks like he regained his senses. He's got knocked out again by that right. Zaragoza still fighting. I thought we were going home. I thought it was over.
The question is Lara tired? I mean, he's been on the attack now for most of the round. Throwing rights. Throwing everything. See him take a breath.
Just missed three wild left hands in a row. Does that mean we're going to see the right again shortly?
He'll throw anything, even his head. There goes that uppercut. He thinks he's got something there. And Zaragoza just trying to stay alive.
Sent them backward into the corner.
And rolling over. And it came after they knocked down in the previous round.
Stretched in the previous round. Got up staggering around in a circle.
And yet he's still there. What does that say about Zaragoza?
Man's got either leg in his shoes or a chin of iron. Here's the knockdown.
First knockdown of the round, and it took us over tea kettle.
We go into round number six. And may well be the last one.
Miraculously. Miraculously.
The champion, Daniel Zaragoza of Mexico, in the white, having been put down once in the fourth by Happy Lora, the challenger from Colombia in black, twice in the fifth, Stephen Bass, Burt Randolph Sugar, Tamiami Fairgrounds in Miami, Florida. And how do you have it scored?
I don't get scored, Mr. Basically, I have 6 points. Spread between Lora and Zaragoza. I did have a 10-7 win in the last round.
That's what I did, and I've got an 8-point spread. I've got a 50-42.
I have a 49-43. And I don't think it makes any difference.
And here's Zaragoza, still on his feet, still punching. In fact, he caught Happy Lora to the right. Now he catches him to the left of the body. I don't know. Do you think Lora may be spent here?
Well, the question is, as much that as the recuperative powers of Zaragoza. He looked out 3 times.
The first time, as we point staggered around in a circle like he didn't even know where the ring was.
He was on pure speedo.
And in round five, one backward somersault from the right hand into the corner, and then a solid left right behind his own right kidney.
A devastating body punch. And here he is. And the irony is he's carrying the action.
Carrying the fight now to Lora. Lora may be taking a breather here.
I think the fans are, too. Look at him. They finally sat down.
Lora now up on his toes, backing away. This is the way he was in the first two rounds. And then three, four, five, and five coming at Zaragoza like he meant to knock him out. He tried.
He came so close. If a man was ever knocked out standing on his feet, that was Zaragoza.
Looked that way in the fourth, for sure. Lora trying to work underneath now.
Happy Lora was happy for a couple seconds there.
Well, there's Zaragoza with the left of the body. And no, it is not round one. Contrary to what you see on the screen, I think the graphics people got a little excited after the last round.
I didn't think they'd have, they probably were trying to start this over again. I think they have to go backwards.
Well, now they've got round six up there. And Lora leading with the right again. But these punches don't look like they have the same steam you had the last few rounds.
Well, he was lining up. He looked like Karina Bellin's leg coming over top of the fast break.
There's Happy Lora getting out of the way of punches.
It's your call. It's your turn.
Round number seven, WBC Bantamweight Championship of the World. Daniel Zaragoza, who may well be the ex-champion in a couple of rounds, but still is the champion now, in white, going against Miguel Happy Lora of Colombia in black. I'm Stephen Bass, working with me, Burt Randolph Sugar. We're at the Tamiami Fairgrounds in Miami, Florida. Burt, how do you have it scored?
Well, I have Lora ahead, big surprise, but I've got him ahead by 5 points here, going into the seventh round. I gave the second round, only the second time I've done this, to Zaragoza, the only man with three punches.
I gave Zaragoza only the sixth round. Zaragoza on his back in round four, on his back in round five, and on his knees in round five.
Whoa,
good left hand.
And the fans were on their feet in round five, but they've now settled down.
And Zaragoza seems to have passed the crisis point. Fires a left hand in there on Lora. Lora now seems to have gotten his second win. Last round, he was pretty tired. I think he might have thrown a lot of juice in the rounds three, four, and five.
Well, as we go into the second half of the fight, and there goes Lora giving the lead right. Is it for Zaragoza too little? Too late.
Another right.
Lead right. Bam, bam.
That's the way to fight a lefty, they say. Oh, with those lead right hands. There's Zaragoza landing the left, and then the backhand pull with the left.
At least he gets more in the fight now than he did in 3-4-5.
Well, five must have woke him up. If it didn't put him to sleep, it woke him up.
It almost put him to sleep for a long time.
But Lora started out this fight moving away from Zaragoza in the first two rounds, and ever since then, he's been right in front of him, and he's pretty much been the aggressor.
He's right there. He's right there. Looking for a place to put that right hand. Which is what started it all in the third round. Boom, 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 boom. Every punch. It's a little quieter, though. And Zaragoza, I think, would rather have it this way.
And then Lora kind of set him up for that right hand in the fourth round. When early in the round, he threw nothing but left hands.
It's a good left hand, but Zaragoza lost something knocking it down, and Lora lost something leaping out. So while it landed, it didn't have the effect of the earlier punches by Lora.
There's Lora bobbing, leaving, and getting out of the way of what would have been a three-punch combination.
Yeah, it was a three-punch combination. And zero.
Good right hand by Lora on the jaw again. I like the way Zaragoza gets his left hand up to block after the punch has hit him. We go into round number eight, WBC. WBC Bantamweight Championship of the World, 118 pounds. Daniel Zaragoza in the right, the champion, sucking up a right hand right there. And a right left from Happy Lora. Happy Lora of Colombia, the challenger in black. Steven Bass, Burton, without sugar, I don't have time to say all this. The punches are being thrown in absolute bushels here by Happy Lora. Lora's right back where he was in round 4 and 5. Took a two-round breather, Burt. That's Steven Bass and Burt Randolph Sugar, Tamiami Fairgrounds, Miami, Florida.
I'm still sitting here and go, bam, bam. Because he just lines up and here it comes.
Well, it looked like Lora took a little breather in the last two rounds. I scored the last two for Zaragoza.
And I split them even. One Zaragoza, one Lora. So I think our scoring is back in front.
But here's Lora now coming at him again like he was in 3, 4, and 5. Good left hand.
He twisted his head like Michael Keaton in Beetlejuice.
Solid left hook right on the jaw.
I got it. I'm back.
Yes. I have to explain things twice around this arena.
Only if you know how to speak Spanish.
Yes. Let's twice. I always told you English is my second language. I had no first.
Well, Lora's on the attack in this round. And that standing really looks like he means business here.
And he meant business in 4 and 5 as well.
Zaragoza, I don't think, has figured out yet that he's not as fast as Happy Lora.
Maybe he's hoping he is. Maybe he's hoping that somehow, some way, somewhere, he can wear him down.
You know, Lora will run out of gas.
But Lora does not look like he's running out of gas. He takes breathers and comes right back.
Another solid overhand right, lead right hand. Left to the body, right to the body. He covers up with his own left. Wild with the lead right there. Wild with the lead right there. And a good left hook by Zaragoza. Another left on the jaw by Lora. A hoppy man doing his hoppy thing on a very hoppy Zaragoza.
Zaragoza is trying hard, but it just ain't enough.
The definition of a fighter with heart?
Oh, yes. Zaragoza, he gives you 200% of what he has. Unfortunately, what he has ain't enough.
It doesn't appear to be, and but interestingly enough, as you said, he gives you 3 minutes every round.
He's there.
All shopping malls are just alike, except for the
WBC Bantamweight Championship of the World. Daniel Zaragoza of Mexico, the champion, getting beat up here by Happy Lora of Colombia.
Happy.
Steven Bass, Burt Randolph Sugar, Tamiami Fairgrounds in Miami, Florida. I've got Lora comfortably ahead.
I've got more than comfortably ahead.
Of course, that has to do with him having knocked Zaragoza on his butt in round 4.
And in round 5, twice.
Twice in round 5. Lora started out the fight on his bicycle a little bit. And now he's talking to Zaragoza here.
He's
him. Talking to him, punching him.
He looks like he's traded his bicycle for a howitzer. I mean, there's no reason to go anywhere. Stand in front of him, wind up with your right, throw it overhand, let's go.
He's talking to Zaragoza here. I don't know what he's saying, but it probably is not anything that's complimentary.
And even if it is complimentary, like you're doing a hell of a job, it would be a fib.
A happy man right in front of Zaragoza. Zaragoza landing the left right in that case.
Zaragoza is trying his daggone best.
Another right to the body by Lora. Lora gives up a little shuffle and he takes a left to the body. Lora misses the wild right. I think he's getting a little overconfident here, Burt.
I think it was. I'll throw the right and go down. Boom, boom. Look at that. It's just, I'm lining up with my right. Here I come, ready or not. And here come the fans, back on their feet again.
But now, those punches that put Zaragoza down in 4 and 5, they're not having the same effect here. And it It's not the war about getting set. He is. Look at that. He got set and threw that shot to the body.
And he's done everything but dig in with his cleats. And this is where Albert Pauley hit a home run 500 feet.
It's going to be a race. But you got to give him all the credit in the world. He stood in there.
Well, right now, Zaragoza's best punch has been the right jaw to the left jaw.
Stephen Bass, Burt Randolph, Sugar, Tamiami Fairgrounds. I like the way that rolls off the tongue. Miami, Florida. Lora comfortably ahead on my scorecard.
I mean, comfortable would be very charitable. We've got him up by 9 points with two to go.
I've got him up, 89-97, so that's 8.
998.
Really quick recap, of course, in the first two rounds, Lora was bouncing around, moving away, and then in the third, he decided to stand and fight, stepped into the middle of the ring, started pouring in right-hand leads. In round number four, he laid out Zaragoza, had him wobbling around on his feet in circles. In round five, had him on his back, and then a solid left hand to the kidney dropped him.
But look at Zaragoza. He is trying everything and anything, and his fight, if anything, is getting better.
He seems to be getting stronger. Lora has hit him with everything. He's talking to him now. How do you like this? How do you like this?
I said, you know what it is? It's like, why don't you fall down? I'm tired.
There he almost did fall down. He almost went down from the left right there.
And yet he pushes Lora away. Let me at you again.
Right, here he comes. Look at him. Left to the bottom, left to the head. Tucks up the left, scores with the left. He doesn't know how to give it up. This kid's got a will of iron.
He's also got a jaw.
And he's got a jaw.
Again, as I say, his best punch has been, depending on the round, the right jaw to the left glove, or the left jaw in the third round to the right glove. And here he is in the 11th round.
And here's Lora talking at him, throwing punches at him, talking to him.
And you know what? Lora is getting hit in this round as he hasn't been hit in the fight before. Even his ducking doesn't get out of the way now.
Lora is scoring punches in there, but those punches do not have anywhere near the speed or velocity they had in the earlier rounds. He's tired. He's beaten on Zaragoza until he's almost ready to fall himself.
And he staggered Zaragoza, and he staggered him again, and he can't follow it up.
And here comes Zaragoza, back throwing punches. Championship on the line. That's Miguel Lora, the challenger, in the black, walking away at Zaragoza while throwing punches. You would think that Lora would be backing away in this round. Look at him. He's talking, he's yelling at him, and throwing punches with both hands. He's not going to give the 12th round to Zaragoza.
And Zaragoza doesn't seem to care. Punches, talking. It's not only sticks and stones can hurt, can break my bones. It's punches can, but I don't care.
And Lora smiles at Zaragoza. He's laughing at him. And Zaragoza didn't like it.
He gave him a shoulder.
Gave him a little shoulder inside. Now they're jawing away at each other again. Zaragoza Still coming after being down once in round four, twice in round five, staggered in the last round.
Twice.
You would think that Lora, having this fight in his pocket, would be up on his toes, bouncing away, keeping him off with the jab. Oh, no. Come on, he said. Let's go. We're not finished. We got 2 minutes to go yet. We can do more. Let's keep fighting.
And Zaragoza will accommodate him. Zaragoza will accommodate him fighting, and it's amazing. 12th round. Zaragoza, though they're not of the same intensity as those of Lara, is carrying the action. Who thought we'd see a 12th round? Who thought we'd see Zaragoza throwing punches like this?
And who thought you'd see Lara with the fight completely in the bag, throwing punches with him toe-to-toe? No backing up, no moving away. Look at this, he's moving Zaragoza back. Another solid right hand. He's going right to the 12th round, battering away. And Zaragoza has a punch. This is pretty dangerous stuff for Lara. And talking to him, telling him.
And the fans love it. The fans love it.
Well, Lara may be taking the title, but he's not going to take this man's pride. No way. Look at this guy fight. Lora talking to him, firing in punches. That's a good way to get your jaw broken, isn't it?
Oh, he's happy.
Winding down to the end. Lora still in front of him. As we come up to the last bell, these two still have the... Now Lora decides to move away. Goes to the ropes and gets hit. Well, maybe this wasn't such a hot idea.
I don't need this. I want the belt, not a hit. I don't want to get belted, I want to get a belt. And Zaragoza is still landing.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Of a surprise there.
Comes close to what we have.
At any rate, what were the scores that you have up there?
Well, we had 118-107, 116-109, 115-110, all for the new WBC Bantamweight champion, Miguel. Happy Lara. There he is. We were 117-109. We weren't too bad at this.
No, we were.
We got to do this again.
Yep, scores are up there on the screen. And what can we say? We saw an excellent fight, one-sided, as I said.
It's unusual to see an excellent one-sided fight.
And I'm sure that we're going to be seeing Happy Lara on the Cavalcade of Boxing again, probably defending his newly won title.
No, this is one good fighter. Zaragoza, please take nothing away from this man.
This is Stephen Bass for Burt Randolph Sugar, rounding third and being thrown out at home. And we'll see you next week on the Cavalcade of Boxing.